St. Gemma's Art and Needlework and www.faithcrafts.com are happy to present a quilting project, I Heart Pie Potholders. In the first video of this two-part series, we cut our fabric, basted our layers, and did some quilting. Now let's continue, starting with basting our backing. Lay down the backing piece, wrong side up, and center the quilted piece on top. Thread base about a quarter inch around all edges. Once you're done, remove pins in first line basting stitches that you did in first video. Now we need to square up this square. The finished piece should be an 8-inch square, so use a tape measure and measure from side to side and see if it arrives at this measurement. If all the cutting and quilting was done correctly, the quilted layer should be 8 inches, and the backing will extend a little bit at each end. It works out with my example here, but if you find some unevenness, mark and trim where needed. All I have to do with my example is trim away the backing. A quilter's square lap board would really help in this instance. Okay, let's move on to something different. Let's make the hanging loops that will go at the corners of the finished potholders. Cut out a 1.5-inch bias strip that is 5 inches long. You can use some of your store-bought quilt binding for this. Just press out all the folds. Now fold the piece in half lengthwise and press. Then fold the long, raw edges to the center crease you just made. Press. Finally, fold in half lengthwise again and press. Move to the machine and stitch along the two folds using a straight stitch. Okay. Now we're going to stitch the binding to the potholder. Starting at the bottom of the potholder, stitch the binding, leaving about 5 inches excess. Stop about a quarter inch from corner. Remove and cut threads. To make a mitered corner, fold the binding at a 45-degree angle up and away from the potholder. Then fold back down so that it is even with the next side. Stitch from corner to a quarter inch away from the next corner and repeat around. The mitered corner on the right side should look like this. After working all the way around and stitching the two ends together, trim away the excess and open up the seam. Stitch over final section of binding. Moving on to sewing the binding at the back. Turn down binding, and while making sure the fold of the binding is past the stitching and basting, Slip stitch in place using a double-threaded needle. And this is how to stitch at the corners. Here's the potholder once the binding has been sewn. Now let's put those hanging loops on. You can attach it at either top corner. To do this, fold under one end of the loop and place at front corner. Hold in place with your fingers. Fold under other end and place at same location on back side. Finger pin and stitch in place. I make two lines of stitching for the loops for extra strength. And there you have it. I Heart Pie potholders that always make a bold statement and will last for years to come. This video was brought to you by St. Gemma's Art and Needlework and www.favecrafts.com.